Good evening. We begin by acknowledging that this event takes place on the ancestral territory of the Puyallup tribe, whose relationship with the land continues to this day. We respectfully acknowledge and honor the history and presence of Indigenous students, staff, and faculty here at Puget Sound. We who are guests on this land offer our gratitude for the opportunity to make music together here. The School of Music strives to recognize, include, and respect all of the peoples and musical traditions that make up our community. Good evening and welcome to our second Jacobsen series performance of the semester. My name is Tracy Doyle, director of the School of Music. This evening's faculty recital features violinist Maria Sampen, joined by Oksana Ijoskina, Eli Shenever, Timothy Christie, and Alistair McRae. We are delighted you are here, and we know you will enjoy this evening's performance. Thank you.
Okay, I have a lot of technology, although I don't think this is on. Is it on now? Is there something special that I need to do, folks in the booth, to turn this on? Now it's on? Is it on? I don't think it's on. I can talk really loudly, though. So. So thank you all so much for being here tonight, and thank you for those of you who are joining us streaming in other parts of the country. Wow, it's so exciting to play for an audience. And. American composers of the 20th century. He wrote over 150 compositions, including 5 symphonies, 8 operas, and a ballet, and he won 2 Guggenheim fellowships. He was responsible for a lot of firsts in his life. He was his symphony number 1, which was titled the Afro American Symphony was the first symphony to be performed by a major orchestra that was composed by a black composer. He was the first black musician to conduct a major symphony orchestra in concert. And he was also the first black composer to have an opera produced by a major company in the United States. The Suite for Violin Piano, which we just heard, was written in 1943. And his inspiration came from the work of 3 African-American artists whose artwork you saw featured in the slides while we were performing. Each of these pieces, the art pieces, were created in the 1930s during the Harlem Renaissance. The next piece on the program is a beautiful work by Rina Esmail. And I put the program notes on the screen here, but not being sure if you could read them all quickly, and I'm going to switch the slide here as I start to play. I'm going to read her words, and because I think they describe the piece that you're going to hear so perfectly. And interestingly enough, this whole program, like, conceptually for me, started with this particular piece. And in particular, the poem that inspired Ms. Esmail to write this piece. So she writes, "Sometimes a poem just reaches into your chest and grabs your heart. That was my feeling the first time I read Daniel Ledinsky's translation of Heifetz's, that's hard to say actually, but a beautiful poem that begins, 'When the violin can forgive the past, the heart starts singing.' At the moment I first read this poem, I was working on a piece for choir and cello. I scrapped the entire thing and started over, setting the text. The opening of the choral piece is a cello solo that feels like a series of questions. It searches for that forgiveness that makes the heart sing. The solo violin version sat in sketches for years and finally came to life at the perfect moment. My husband, Vijay Gupta, gave the 2020 Nancy Hanks Lecture on the Arts and Public Policy for Americans for the Arts. He decided to open the lecture, given remotely in a pandemic and amidst the deep racial issues in America, by talking about forgiveness and playing this piece. When the violin is in a Hindustani North Indian rag called Charukeshi. I love this rag because it's so simple, and yet it can reveal emotions that range from the depths of darkness to the most beautiful, piercing light. It feels like winding through a mountain pass at sunset. It can be just a few steps between shadow and blinding light, between the tightest crevasses and vast, breathtaking vistas. To me, Charukeshi is the sound of the soul cracking open." Well, in the next slide, you'll see the poem that inspires the work. I welcome you to read that along with my performance today. Thank you all for being here, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the program.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.